Hi everyone, my name is Pooja Rawat and I'm back with this current affairs series on the agriculture and rural development for the upcoming NABARD examination. I know it's been a long time since I've taken my last session. Unfortunately, me and my parents were tested positive for COVID-19, because of which I couldn't continue these classes. But now we are fine and I just hope everything runs smooth. And you should remember that NABARD notification will be out by the first or the second week of June. So those who haven't started their preparation yet, I guess this is the time you should pull your socks up, give your 100%, and this is a great opportunity for all of you guys, right? So let's just begin our session. I would like to mention, those who are watching this channel or this video for the first time, you can subscribe to our channel and you can press this bell icon so that you don't miss on the latest updates. You can also join our Telegram group. Okay, here you'll get access to the different quizzes and the discussion, and you'll also be updated regarding the latest notifications about all the exams, right? So let's just begin our session. This is the first question, and it says, consider the following statement regarding Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Ann Yojana. Okay. So Yojana hai Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Ann Yojana, which has been extended for another 2 months, that is May to June 21. Okay. This scheme was launched last year, if you remember. Okay. COVID ke situation, this COVID pandemic ki wajah se last year 2020 mein, this scheme was launched, and it was started for around 3 months, April to June, and then it was continued for November 20. After that, it was discontinued. But now, owing to the second wave of COVID-19, this scheme has been relaunched, or I would say the phase 3 has been launched, and this has been extended till June 21. Okay, so first statement here is, it aims to allocate free of cost food grains at the rate 5 kg per person per month. Okay, absolutely correct. So under this scheme, every person would be entitled to get this free of cost food grains. So each person would get 5 kg of food grains per month. Okay. The second statement here is, beneficiaries should be covered under the National Food Security Act 2013. This one is also correct. So NFSA 2013 ke under kya tha, NFSA Act kya tha, iske under subsidized food grain was given to the poor people. So around 2/3 of the total population was covered under this. And the significance of this act is the food security in India, jo uske approach hua karti thi. Earlier it was like a welfare approach. Now it has been shifted to the right-based approach, because this is a legal entitlement. Yahan jo food grains aapko milega subsidized rate pe, this is your legal entitlement. This is your right to get this subsidized food grain. Okay. So this was a major, I would say, a watershed in the food security system in India. So both of these statements are correct. So C option would be right here. Okay. So let's just read about this scheme in detail. So Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Ann Yojana is a part of Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan package. So this was a package that was launched last year to help the poor fight the battle against COVID-19. Okay, so those who are not financially well off, to help them fight this pandemic situation, government has launched this Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan package, and this Ann Yojana was under that particular package. So the nodal ministry here is Ministry of Finance. The Ministry of Finance ka kaam yahan pe allocation ka hai mostly. To baki jo distribution ka kaam hota hai, that is a public distribution ke under jo food grains distribute kiye jaate hain, that comes under the Ministry of Consumer Affairs wale jo ministry uske under aate hain. Theek hai? So this was initially announced for a 3-month period. We have already discussed this, till 2020, covering around 80 crore ration card holders, which is covered under the NFSA, that is the National Food Security Act 2013. Now April 2021, the government had announced its decision to restart this Yojana. Okay. Now the scheme aimed at providing each person who are covered under the NFSA with an additional 5 kg of grains for free. Okay. In addition to the 5 kg of subsidized food grains that has already been given under the PDS system, that is the public distribution system. So, pehle hi 5 kg food grains was given at the subsidized rate and at the rate of rupees 3 for rice, okay, and 2 for wheat and 1 for coarse grain. Okay. So these were the subsidized rates under the PDS system. Now this additional 5 kg grains would be given at no cost. Okay. Now what is missing in this year? So this scheme has been restarted, but one component is missing. Earlier in the last year, the government has been providing this pulse. Okay, 1 kg of pulses, that is the chana, was given free of cost to each household, but this component is missing this year. Okay, so this was about Garib Kalyan Ann Yojana. You should remember this. The second question here is, recently the Telangana government declared a complete ban on the controversial herbicide which is used rampantly by the farmers to kill weeds in the HTBT cotton crop. ठीक है, पहली बात तो ये HTBT कॉटन क्रॉप क्या है ये आपको पता होनी चाहिए. दिस इज द हर्बिसाइड टॉलरेंट कॉटन क्रॉप. ओके, सो आपको पता होगा दीज आर GM क्रॉप्स, जेनेटिकली मॉडिफाइड क्रॉप्स. अब जेनेटिकली मॉडिफाइड क्रॉप्स में क्या होता है, नॉर्मली जो भी आपकी प्योर क्रॉप होती है, ओरिजिनल क्रॉप होती है, उसके जीन्स को मॉडिफाई किया जाता है टू मेक देम पेस्ट रेजिस्टेंट और एनी प्रॉपर्टीज दैट यू वॉन्ट टू एड इन टू दैट. ओके, सो HTBT कॉटन जो है इसको जेनेटिकली मॉडिफाई किया गया है, जो सॉइल बैक्टीरियम है उसके जीन्स को इसमें कॉटन क्रॉप में इंट्रोड्यूस किया गया था. सो इन इंडिया में अगर बात करें, इनिशियल 2 वर्जन जो कॉटन के थे, दैट इज़ द क्राइवन GM कॉटन के जो थे, क्राइवन AB एंड क्राइवन BC, सो दीज 2 क्रॉप्स वर अलाउड फॉर कमर्शियल प्रोडक्शन. ओके, till now HTBT cotton crop is not commercially allowed to be grown, lekin jo Indian farmers hai they are still growing it. Why they are growing it? Iska ek benefit hai. Cotton crop mein ke saath saath kaafi sare weeds jo hote hain, jaise ki unwanted plants hote hain, wo bhi grow ho jate hain. So farmers ke liye bahut hi mushkil ho jata hai herbicide ko spray karna cotton crop mein, because कॉटन इज़ नॉट टॉलरेंट टू दीज हर्बिसाइड्स. तो वीड्स के साथ साथ कॉटन क्रॉप को भी डैमेज होता है, बट फार्मर्स आर यूजिंग दिस कॉटन क्रॉप बिकॉज इट इज़ हर्बिसाइड टॉलरेंट. दे कैन ईजिली स्प्रे दैट हर्बिसाइड टू किल द अनवॉन्टेड प्लांट्स, टू किल द वीड्स, सो दैट दे कैन गेट रिड ऑफ दीज वीड्स एंड वुड गेट दिस कॉटन क्रॉप एंड दे कुड ईजिली सेव दिस कॉटन क्रॉप, जो प्रोडक्शन है वुड इंक्रीज. ठीक है, तो इस अब ये जो हर्बिसाइड है जो अभी बैन किया गया है तेलंगाना गवर्नमेंट, यू हैव टू टेल विच ऑफ दीज इज दैट. सो यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट हर्बिसाइड. सो आई थिंक दिस इज क्लियर व्हाट इज HTBT कॉटन क्रॉप एंड दैट दिस इज नॉट कमर्शियली अलाउड टू बी ग्रोन इन इंडिया, बट मोस्ट ऑफ द फार्मर्स आर ग्रोइंग इट अराउंड. इन फैक्ट 40-50% लैंड विच इज अंडर द कॉटन कल्टिवेशन इज बीन कवर्ड बाय दिस मॉडिफाइड क्रॉप, GM क्रॉप. Okay, so here we are talking about this herbicide. So these are glyphosate, dichlorophenoxyacetic acid, dinoseb and butachlor. So the correct herbicide here is glyphosate. This one is banned. Okay, you should remember this. It was currently in news. Let's move on to the third question. And this says, which of the following state is regarded as a seed bowl of the country? The seed bowl of the country jo hai, yani ki jo maximum इंडिया की जो सीड रिक्वायरमेंट है उसको फुलफिल कर रहा है वो स्टेट कौन सा है. द ऑप्शन हेयर आर तेलंगाना, आंध्र प्रदेश, महाराष्ट्र एंड पंजाब. सो करेक्ट आंसर हेयर इज तेलंगाना. राइट नाउ इट्स केटरिंग टू द 60% नीड्स ऑफ द इंडियन सीड रिक्वायरमेंट. ओके, सो जो भी इंडिया की सीड रिक्वायरमेंट है उसका 60% इज टेकन केयर बाय दिस तेलंगाना स्टेट ओनली. सो you should also remember this. Now let's start with this fourth question, and it says, consider the following statement regarding Kisan Suvidha app. Okay, so recently this Kisan Suvidha app was launched, and these are particular statements regarding this, and you have to identify which of these are correct. So first statement here is, it is developed by National Informatics Center. So National Informatics Center kya hai? You should remember this. It is an attached office. ठीक है? Attached office under what? Under MeitY. MeitY kya hai? This is a Ministry of Information, Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. ठीक है? So this one is an attached office under MeitY. And NIC जो है, आपको अगर हम देखें तो Digital India का जो campaign के हम बात करते हैं, उसको reality में कैसे execute करना है, वो it's all taken care by this National Informatics Center. So, जो भी आपका informatic technologically infrastructure है, that would be provided by this NIC. Okay, so e-governance services provide करता है to the central government, to the state government, as well as the UT government. So, this is a very important body under MeitY. तो आपने देखा, notice भी क्या होगा कि जितने भी government apps होते हैं, that are normally developed by this National Informatics Center. So this one is absolutely correct. This Kisan Suvidha app is developed by NIC. Second statement here is, it aims to bring all agricultural schemes or services under one umbrella for access by the farmers via single interface. Absolutely correct. So Kisan Suvidha, jaise ki name hi suggest karte, farmers के लिए सुविधा प्रोवाइड करेगा. तो कैसे सुविधा प्रोवाइड करेगा? देयर मल्टीपल सर्विसेज, देयर मल्टीपल स्कीम्स, गवर्नमेंट स्कीम्स दैट आर रनिंग फॉर द फार्मर्स. इसका काम ये होगा कि सारी स्कीम्स को एक अम्ब्रेला के अंडर लेकर आएगा, यानी कि वन इंटरफेस वुड प्रोवाइड ऑल द सर्विसेज रिलेटेड टू क्रॉप इंश्योरेंस और पीएम किसान, योर क्रेडिट सब्सिडी प्रोग्राम्स, your extension services, marketing, organic farming, soil fertility related services, all these services would be provided under this one umbrella scheme or app, that is the Kisan Suvidha app. So this statement is also correct. Third statement here is, it is available in four local languages, that is Hindi, Gujarati, Assamese and Malayalam. This one is also correct. Okay, so right now this app is available in four local languages, and these are these Hindi, Gujarati, Assamese and Malayalam. So all these statements are correct, and the correct option would be D, that is all of the above. So remember all these points, these are very important, and so let's move on to the next question. This is the question number fifth, that is NAFIS, a national level survey. Okay, this is a national level survey that offers a comprehensive overview of the status of livelihood. So, two things are telling: livelihood ka status, rural people's ka, and the level of financial inclusion of the rural population. So, two things are telling: livelihood ke baare mein and financial inclusion ke baare mein. So, you have to identify which of these bodies is presently conducting this survey. Okay. So here are RBI, SEBI, Ministry of Finance and NABARD. The correct option here is NABARD. Okay, so we'll be discussing about this survey in detail. So you just remember, NABARD is the body that is responsible to conduct this survey, NAFIS. Okay, so NAFIS stands for NABARD All India Rural Financial Inclusion Survey. So that why NAFIS का फुल फॉर्म मैंने इसीलिए लास्ट स्लाइड में नहीं मेंशन किया था, बिकॉज इट ऑलरेडी इंक्लूड द नेम ऑफ NABARD. ओके, सो NABARD ऑल इंडिया रूरल फाइनेंशियल इंक्लूजन सर्वे. बट अगर ये एग्जाम में आता है तो आई थिंक दे वुड बी आस्किंग दिस नेम ओनली, NAFIS सर्वे. ओके, सो यू शुड रिमेंबर दिस सिंस इट्स अ NABARD एग्जामिनेशन, एंड आई थिंक वो सारे इनिशिएटिव जिसके लिए NABARD रिस्पॉन्सिबल है, यू शुड बी थोरो अबाउट दैट. So NAFIS, this survey was launched in 2016-17 as a national level survey that would provide the overall status of the livelihood and the financial inclusion of the rural people. So this is conducted by NABARD after every 3 years. So you should also remember this period. This would be conducted after every 3 years, and the first survey was done in 2016-17, and the report was published by NITI Aayog in 2018-19. Okay, so remember these points. What are the findings under this survey? First thing, it shows the average agriculture household income is around 8,931 per month in 2016-17. तो 2016-17 में ये सर्वे कराया गया था और इसके अकॉर्डिंग जो अगर एवरेज इनकम निकाली जाए एक एग्रीकल्चर हाउस होल्ड की, सो दिस इज़ अराउंड 8,931. Another finding is cultivation is still a major source of income, so which cater to around 35% of the income. Okay, so agriculture is the main source, cultivation. This is followed by daily wage laborers. Okay, सबसे पहले cultivation का major source है 35%, then agriculture जो daily wage laborers हैं that accounts for 34% of the income, and livestock rearing contributes only 8% of their income. ठीक है, तो जो भी cattle rearing होती है, goat, sheep और cows and buffaloes, whatever these livestocks are, this contributes only 8% of their total income. ठीक है, another finding is 41% of the rural households are indebted. Okay, so this is important. Around 41% people are indebted, of which majority, that is 43%, are agriculture households. तो total rural households अगर देखें तो उसका 41% जो है that are under some kind of debt. इसमें से भी जो majority है, I would not say majority, but 43% are the agriculture households. ठीक है, अब कौन से states में सबसे ज़्यादा indebted households हैं, सबसे ज़्यादा जो लोग हैं वो under loaning वाली condition में हैं, that is गुजरात, महाराष्ट्र, तेलंगाना, जम्मू एंड कश्मीर एंड हिमाचल प्रदेश. तो दीज स्टेट्स हैव द मोस्ट इंडेटेड हाउसहोल्ड्स, रूरल हाउसहोल्ड्स. ठीक है, और इसीलिए आपने देखा होगा कि इन स्टेट्स में स्पेशली महाराष्ट्र और कर्नाटक वाले स्टेट्स में फार्मर सुसाइड्स जो है वो काफ़ी ज़्यादा है ना. अनदर फाइंडिंग वॉज ओनली 1/4 ऑफ द टोटल रूरल हाउसहोल्ड्स हैव एनी काइंड ऑफ इंश्योरेंस. ठीक है, तो फाइनेंशियल इंक्लूजन की जब हम बात करते हैं तो हम ये देखते हैं कि हाउ मेनी पीपल आर डायरेक्टली और इनडायरेक्टली कनेक्टेड टू फॉर्मल फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशंस, कितने लोग इंश्योरेंस के अंडर कवर्ड हैं, है ना. तो अगर हम किसी भी तरीके के इंश्योरेंस की बात करते हैं, इधर लाइफ इंश्योरेंस और हेल्थ इंश्योरेंस, व्हीकल एक्सीडेंट, सो ओनली 1/4 ऑफ द रूरल हाउसहोल्ड्स आर कवर्ड अंडर दिस इंश्योरेंस, एनी काइंड ऑफ इंश्योरेंस, लाइक ओनली 25% पीपल. Then around 49% of the total rural households and 53% of the agriculture households have any kind of savings in any financial institution. So this one is also important because less than 50% people are those who do not save anything or they are not linked with any financial institution, not saving anything. So this is one of the condition I would say ki agar koi log save nahi kar rahe hain, that means they're not being eligible or they're not being able to fulfill their basic needs, hai na. Hum save kabhi nahi kar pate jab hamari jo basic needs hain, hamari jo food security ki baat kare, housing facilities hai, health, education hai, hum usi ko agar fulfill nahi kar pa rahe hain to we will not be able to save anything. So agar aap percentage nikalte hain ki why majority of the rural households are not saving or are not being connected to any sort of formal financial institution, it shows an underlying situation. एक underlining situation है जो आपको समझनी चाहिए कि these are poor people and these are not able to fulfill their basic needs and that's why they're not left with any surplus to save anything, right? So try to understand the underlying situation, the basic situation, कि why it's happening, right? So in that way you'll better be able to understand it and remember it. So this is it with this particular session. I hope you like it and we'll be back with another session soon, right? Thank you so much. Take care.